Hello. It's good to see you. Today we are going to be polishing some silver plate. We have several different sized pieces here. We have a very large server here. We have things like this bowl. I think that's going to look really nice. And a platter. It's already pretty shiny. You can see pretty well in there. This one shouldn't be too bad. It says Merry Christmas on it. It's kind of hard to see, but it does. The main thing with this that we're going to focus on is the edges. Like along here, you can see that they've started to look a little tarnished. We even have a real silver bell. From the year 2000. It looks like a little piece is broken off the end, but that's okay. I think we can still polish it. It is silver plated. Then we have this little bowl here. Quite a bit of tarnish around the edges on here, down in this part. The underside's not too bad, unless you look along the edges again, around this way. And then finally, we have this little tray here. It's not too bad in the middle. Looks all right. Some of these still have stickers on them from where I purchased them. These all came from thrift stores, all of these. What I do is I buy them, we polish them up, and then I donate them back to local charities to sell to raise money for their charitable causes. So, let's get started. All right, we're going to start with the smaller pieces, like this one here, this nice bowl. I've put on some gloves to keep this tarnish remover off my hands. We have Tarnax tarnish remover. We've used this several times to clean the silver plate. I just noticed this one has a little dent. I can't really do anything about that, but we'll clean it up and see if we can at least remove some of this tarnish and make it look pretty. Okay, so I'm just going to take my paper towel here, and I also have paper towel down here to protect the table. I think I'm just going to start with half, just one little rectangle here. I'm going to fold it. Let's go like that. Okay. Shake it out. Open it up. And I'm just going to pour a little on here. I'm going to put the lid back on it. Now, let's see how it does. My goodness. Let's turn it this way and put a little more on there. Sometimes the tarnish can be very stubborn. I'm just going to apply some and let it kind of sit there for a minute. Okay. Well, it's making a pretty big difference inside. Get down in that little groove right there. It's almost like a layer of rust or something. Let's try a new paper towel. Some pretty heavy duty tarnish. We haven't even gotten to the underside. It definitely looks different. I'm not sure what I can do about these dark spots. They don't seem to want to come off. Just going around this edge here. I've tried using Q-tips, but I find that just taking a paper towel that's been soaked in the cleaner and just kind of going with the pattern around the edges seems to work just fine. You just mainly want to get that cleaner down in the grooves there. And then come back over it, just kind of run over it like that. The only thing is your paper towel balls up. If I combine these two. See what that does. Well, it looks better than it did. We still have these little dark spots. I don't really know what to do about those. It feels like something, it's almost like rust, but it's not rust. All right, let me get a clean paper towel for that. Underside of this thing. Look at that side compared to that side. Ooh. Okay, well, I think that's about the best I'm going to be able to do for that one. It still has to be rinsed after you finish working with the silver polish. You rinse it and then dry it. I think that's about the best I'm going to be able to do with that one, but it definitely looks better than it did. We do still have some little spots. But otherwise, I think it looks a lot better. You can see a bit of a reflection in it now. You couldn't see that before. So there's the first one. All right, now we're going to work on the bowl. Look at that. So here's how it looks. You can see it has a lot of tarnish here and on the underside too. It's really something. Okay, so we're going to take our paper towel and fold it. You can do it any way you want to. It doesn't matter. I don't think there's really a right or wrong way to do it. If it drips, that's okay. Look where it dripped. It's already removing tarnish. Look at that. You can see. Wow. This is going to be pretty striking, I think. Whoa. That is something. Oh my goodness, look how fast that came off. That is something. And the tarnish is worse up near the rim up here. So that takes a little bit more work. It doesn't come off as easily. Goodness. Well, that just comes right out. Wow. Oh, that is something. Open this up a little. Now, look at that. Wow. Oh my. So if you compare that to this, it's pretty drastic. That is a beautiful transformation there. So let's work on the underside now. I'll just turn it over. I'm just going to keep using the same paper towel for right now. I'm just gonna see. Okay, that's not really doing anything. Wow. Oh, it is a little bit. It's very subtle. Slowly but surely, you can start to see the shine. It's really coming off. Ooh, you can tell. It is making a difference. Here's the part we have cleaned. Here's the part that we have not cleaned. And here's where a little bit of the cleaner dripped down. It made a cool, like a design. Where it dripped. It kind of ran across there. Wow. Ah. going to get another paper towel. Well, it's better. Some of this tarnish is very stubborn. Okay, so it's still gonna have a little bit of a film on it, but what I'm gonna do is rinse it thoroughly and then dry it and wipe it clean with a clean dry cloth to add a little bit of an extra polish to it, but it definitely looks better than it did a few minutes ago. Look at that. Cool. It's nice. And now we have this little tray. At first glance, I wouldn't think that this one would be too difficult. It looks like it should be pretty easy. But sometimes looks can be deceiving. We'll find out. Oh, I dropped some. It already, look at it. Where it runs, it cleans. Wow. Oh my. Whoa, that is drastic. Oh, this is super easy. Look at that, that is amazing. Wow. It's pretty good. That is incredible. Look how beautiful it is. Oh my gosh. That is gorgeous. Okay, let's see what we can do on the back. Ooh. Goodness gracious. Look at this side compared to this side. This is Chippendale International Silver Company. It is amazing how it just comes right off. So there it is. And then after I rinse it and dry it, it will be even shinier than this. That is an amazing transformation. That looks so good. I think that's my favorite one so far. Wow. Beautiful. Look at that. And now we have the silver bell. The little clapper in there. The first thing we're going to do is remove the bow while we clean it. Just take that off. Now, I'm going to see if I can use this one a little more on here. This is the one I just used a minute ago. I'm going to try to keep from ringing it too much. I don't want to summon my servants. I am totally kidding. I would just be summoning myself. I don't have any servants. Ooh, wow. All I did was just this little part here. And look at all that. I'm holding the clapper with my thumb. I don't want to get it on this part because I don't know what that's made of. I'm trying not to get it on that golden colored part. It probably won't hurt it, but I don't know what it is. That looks pretty. And it says, it's interesting because someone has engraved into it Christmas 1999, and then up here it says 2000. So I guess you could use this bell for Christmas and then use it for New Year's too. Good grief, look at all that. Looky there. I'm going to try to get as much of the inside as I can. It's difficult, but I'll try. This was made by the International Silver Company. Handmade, silver plated in India. There's a sticker on the inside. I just read it. There. That's a bit better. So there we have it, a silver bell. I've never had a silver bell. I know the song, the Christmas song, but I've never had a silver bell before. There it is. one little cleaned Christmas 1999 silver bell. Next, we have the happy anniversary plate, the tray. It has happy anniversary engraved into it in script. It's actually not that bad. You can see the imprint where it has happy anniversary a little bit on the underside. Okay, let me remove the sticker. Get as much of it off as I can. I'll get it off with the polish. If I can't get it off with the polish, the tarnish remover, I'll get it off with Goo Gone. That's fine. Oop, I dropped some right there. You see it? Check it out. Oh, that's cleaning up so nicely. Wow, it looks better already. I mean, it looked pretty decent when we started. It's even better now. Well, except for the bit of the price sticker that I didn't get off. I'll get that off when I clean it, but look at that. Wow. Now let's look at the underside. How will this do? Not as shiny of a finish. It's more of a matte finish. So I don't think it's going to shine up as much as the front, but that's okay. We'll still do what we can. That. There we go. Wow. And it gets a little film on it, a little haze. But as soon as, after I rinse it and dry it, it won't have that haze anymore. It'll look like that. Wow, you can see my whole setup. It's pretty awesome. Hey. That is amazing. Look at the shine on that. You can see me. You can see the window, the light fixture, everything. Beautiful. So there we have the happy anniversary platter. And finally, we have the big serving platter tray thing. Like, you could put different little snacks in here. You could put little sandwiches on here. Maybe some cheese and crackers or something. Just whatever you like. It's very heavy. This is the heaviest piece I think we have ever cleaned. I'm curious. I want to see what happens if you just drip a little bit on there. This part is already really shiny for some reason. I didn't do it that way. It was just like that when I got it. I'm going to drip it. I'm just going to drip it. I want to see what it does. Oh, whoa. Look at that. I'm going to do it over here. Wow. Look at that. Oh my goodness. Maybe it won't be too bad. So we're going to take a paper towel again. Oops, I spilled a bunch that time. Okay. Ooh, you can really start to see that pattern, the leaf pattern. And right now, I'm just smearing it around and letting it sit on the surfaces. Oh my word. Wow. There are so many layers of tarnish on this thing. I don't know how much we're really going to be able to do. It's coming off though, you can see it. My word. Here. Just get another one. Just leave it sitting there. Here, spread it out. I think this is the dirtiest one we've had, as far as just the amount of stuff coming off of it. I actually think it's kind of cool. It looks like marble or something. I'm not just saying that because I don't want to do it. Wow. But look how cool it looks. It's like marble almost. It's like got this marbled finish to it. It is really something. Ooh, I think that's about the best we're gonna do for the fronts. Look at that. Gosh, compared to what it was. I mean, yeah, it's not perfect. There's still some dark spots, but it looks better. I kind of like leaving this dark on the edges. I think it looks kind of cool to leave the dark tarnish. That's just me, but. So let's get ready to do the undersod. Okay, you remember how dark the front was? The bottom, the undersod is the same. Ooh. There we have it. Now, once again, I just want to drop. Just I want to do a little drop right here, see what it does. It may not do anything, I don't know. It's, see, I think the tarnish is so thick that it's not even doing anything. Like, it's not even, it doesn't appear to be doing anything. That is some super thick tarnish. Oh, I dribbled some over here. I'm just going to kind of smear it around all over. Oh, it's coming through. Look at that. It's making a difference. Coming off. Believe it or not, it's coming off. It may not look like it. thing is crazy. It is really, really super tarnished. I think that's all I'm going to be able to get off for today. Yeah, I'll work on it some more later, but look at this. I do kind of like the cool marbled look that it has. It's almost like it was done that way deliberately. Yeah, it's really cool. I'll just dry it a little bit before I turn it over. The front gets a little bit of a patina on it when it has sat for a little bit, but again, after I rinse it and dry it, it will be a little shinier than this. But there it is, our last piece of silver plate for today. You can see the pretty tree design there in the middle section. And then we have these two sections here. I think it turned out really nice. Yeah, it's not perfect, but compared to the way it was, I think it's much better. So thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed seeing this process. And I hope that you have a wonderful day. I'll see you again really soon.